I heard this story about my uncle. He stole a porta potty from the side of the interstate a couple years ago. That's exciting. My friend didn't even believe me. He goes, there's no way that he stole that. You have to empty those things out. You're an idiot if you think a porta potty thief thinks things through. This isn't Ocean's 11. He didn't. There's no blueprints involved. He just saw it and he goes, that'll fit in my truck. And someone goes, hell yeah, it will. And then it did. And then it did fit in his truck. I gotta bring people into this family. I gotta meet new people, introduce them to my family that steals porta potties, and I throw babies into ceilings. It's crazy. I was engaged at one point. I was gonna get married. I was engaged. She gave me the ring back, which is that's one of the options. You know, I was really excited about being engaged. Now I'm not engaged. Still really excited about that also now. But at the time, I was bummed. I got the ring back. I told my friend, I was like, she gave me the ring back, man. It's over. And he goes, well, you got the ring. That's good, right? Yeah, that's not what I was going for. I wasn't trying to demonstrate my awesome return policy. What are you thinking? Do you know how this works? I took it hard. I cried. I'm not afraid to admit it. People make fun of you when you cry. Oh, did you cry like a baby? No, I didn't, actually. Babies don't have the lung capacity. I cried like a grown man. Or a small ape, maybe. I cried hard. It's weird when a man cries, you gotta admit that. You can't just walk around crying. When a man cries, that's terrifying. When a woman cries, no offense, we're used to it. We'll just step over you in the street and go about our business, unless we think we can have sex with you. Then we'll apply a light tap to your lower back. It'll be all right, baby girl. When a man cries, I had a stranger come up to me and tell me everything was gonna be all right one day. He's like, everything's gonna be all right. He didn't know that everything was going to be all right. He was just going, hey, when you start shooting people, you're not gonna shoot me, are you? Isn't that what men do when they cry? I cried in the shower, that's confusing. Shower pumps water onto your face, tears are made of water. Halfway into it, you're like, am I even doing this right now? I mean, is this like a dry hump cry or something? Am I practicing to cry later? This is the worst part. We're engaged, we were together for a long time. 3 weeks after our engagement, she got engaged to someone else. That was what I said. Oh, no, boo. Every time I tell people, I would tell people, and I would be like, yeah, she's engaged. And they would be like, she's probably cheating on you. What'd you think of that? Yeah, I did. A lot. A bunch. But I told you 7 seconds ago, you feel like you cracked the case? You feel like you've taken all the clues and analyzed, and you've got it. You've done it? You did it on your own right there? How'd you come to that conclusion? You know how I came to the conclusion was I checked her email, and I found out for sure. I don't wait. I check. I had her email password, so I checked it. I know you're supposed to. I felt bad. Whatever. Here's the difference. I told my friend who's never been in a relationship or been broken up with that I checked her email, and he was like, that's disrespectful, man. That's crazy. Why would you do that? And then I told my friend who has been through a breakup, and he goes, how'd you get that email password? Did you just like a program or something? That's when I realized when you go through a breakup, you should tell everybody what you do, because eventually someone's gonna out-crazy you, and you'll feel better about yourself. You'd be like, I checked your email for a month. They'll be like, I lived in her basement for 6 weeks. And then someone else will be like, I kept her in my basement.